Thorne Middle School proudly presents Into the Woods. Will you please stand at this time for a moment of silence for our troops and the Pledge of Allegiance to our country? I pledge allegiance to the United States of America. We hope that you enjoy the show.
Once upon a time, in a far-off kingdom, lived a young maiden, a sad young lad,
I wish,
a childless baker,
more than life I wish,
with his wife,
more than anything,
more than the moon I wish, more than life
I wish,
more than riches,
I wish my cow would give us some milk,
more than anything,
I wish we had a child,
I want a child, I wish.
You wish to go to the festival?
The poor girl's mother had died.
You, Cinderella, the festival?
The festival? The king's festival?
And her father had taken for his new wife, a woman with two daughters of her own. All three were beautiful of face, but black and vile of heart.
I wish. It's not for me, it's for my grand in the wood. A loaf of bread, please. To bring my poor but humble grand in the wood. Just a loaf of bread, please. Thank you. Into the woods, it's time to go. I hate to leave, I have to though. Into the woods, the time is so. I must begin my journey. Into the woods and through the trees to where I am expecting men. Into the woods to grandmother's house.
You're certain of your way?
The way is clear, the light is good. I have no fear, nor no one should. The woods are just trees, the trees are just woods. I sort of hate to ask if do you have a basket?
Jack, on the other hand, had no grandmother and no father, and his mother,
I wish,
well, she was not quite beautiful.
I wish my son were not a fool. I wish my house was not a mess. I wish the cow was full of milk. I wish the walls were full of gold. I wish a lot of things.
Listen well, son. Milky White must be taken to market.
But mother, no, he's the best cow.
She has given us no milk for a week. We've no food, no money, and no choice but to sell her.
But Milky White is my best friend in the whole world.
Look at her. There are bugs on her dogs. There are flies in her eyes. There's a lump on her rump big enough to be a hunt. And no one keeps a cow for a friend. Fetch the best price you can. Take no less than £5. Are you listening to me?
Yes, no more than £5.
Less than five. Now go.
Because the baker had lost his mother and father in a baking accident, well, at least that's what he believed, he was eager to have a family of his own and was concerned that all efforts until now had failed.
Who might that be?
It's the witch who lives next door.
The witch told the couple that there was a spell on their house.
What spell?
In the past, when your mother was with child, she developed quite an unusual appetite. She took one look at my beautiful garden and told your father what she wants more than anything in the world. Greens, greens, and nothing but greens. Parsley, peppers, cabbage, had a brother?
No!
But you had a sister.
But the witch refused to tell him any more of his sister, not even that her name was Rapunzel.
I thought that I had been more than reasonable, but how was I to know what your father had also hidden in his pocket?
What?
Beans.
Beans?
The special beans. I let him go. I didn't know he'd stolen my beans. I was watching him crawl back over the wall, and then bang, crash in a lightning flash. Well, that's another story, never mind. Anyway, the big day came when I made my claim. But I'll take away the baby. They shrieked and screeched, but I did, and I hid it. Well, she'll never be reached. Your father cried, and your mother died. And for extra measure, I admit it with pleasure. I said, sorry, I'm still not mollified. And I laid a little spell on them. You too, son. That your family tree would always be a barren one! So, there's no more fuss and there's no more seeds, and my garden thrives. You should see my nectarines. And I'm telling you the same I tell kings and queens. Don't ever, never, ever mess around with my greens. Especially the beans!
Then the witch, for purposes of her own, explained how they might lift the spell.
If you wish to have the curse reversed, I'll need a certain potion first. Go to the wood and bring me back, one, the cow as white as milk, two, the cape as red as blood, three, the hair as yellow as corn, four, the slipper as pure as gold. Bring me these before the chime of midnight. In 3 days' time, and you shall have, I guarantee, a child as perfect as child can be. Go to the wood!
What a terrible witch! She's even losing her hair!
Ladies! Our carriage waits!
Please, man, go to the festival.
The festival? You didn't make us the fools of the festival.
Carriage is waiting.
We must be gone.
Good night, Father.
Hello.
I wish.
Look what I found in Father's hunting jacket.
Six beans.
I want the witch's beans.
We'll take them with us.
No, you are not coming. That is fine. Now, what you was I to return with?
Cow is white as milk, the cape is red as blood, the hair is yellow as corn, the slipper is pure as gold,
the cow is... And so the baker reluctantly set off to meet the enchantress's demands. As for Cinderella...
Into the woods to get the thing that makes it worth the journey.
Into the woods to see the king,
to sell the cow,
to make the potion, to see, to sell, to get, to bring, to make, to live, to go to the festival. Into the woods, into the woods, into the woods, and out of the woods, and home before it's dark.
Cinderella had planted a branch at the grave of her mother, and she visited there so often and wept so much that her tears watered it until it had become a handsome tree.
I wish...
What, child? Specify.
balanced everywhere, Milky White. Not to my liking.
Hello, Jack!
How did you know my name?
How much are you asking for the animal?
No less than 5 pounds, sir.
Why, you would be lucky to exchange her for a sack of beans.
Come, Milky White. There are spirits here.
Good day, young lady.
Good day, Mr. Wolf.
Whither away so hurriedly?
To my grandmother's.
And what might be in your basket?
Bread and wine, so grandmother has something good to make her strong.
And where might your grandmother live?
Farther into the forest. Her house stands under 3 large oak trees.
Hello, little girl. What's your rush? You're missing all the flowers. Is someone set for hours? Take your time.
Mother said straight ahead, not slide or be misled.
But slow, little girl, hark and hush. The birds are singing sweetly. You'll miss the birds completely. You're traveling so fleetly.
Goodbye, Mr. Wolf.
Goodbye, little girl.
And hello. Oh. Whoa.
Is harm to come to that little girl? In the red cake?
Forget the little girl and get the cake! There's the cake, get it!
How am I supposed to get it?
You go up to the little thing and you take it!
Ah, oh, my Rapunzel. Listen to her beautiful music.
Get me what I need!
I'll never get the red cape, nor the golden cow, or the yellow slipper. Or was it the yellow cow? And the golden slipper.
The cow is white as milk, the cape is red as blood, the hair is yellow as corn, the slipper is pure as...
What are you doing here?
You forgot your scarf.
You have no business being alone in the woods. Now go home immediately.
I wish to help.
No, the spell is on my house.
A cow as white as milk.
Hello there, young lad.
Hello, sir.
What might you be doing in the middle of the forest with the cow?
I was headed toward Margate, but I seem to have lost my way.
And what are you planning to do there?
And what are you planning on doing there?
Sell my cow, sir, no less than 5 pounds.
5 pounds? And if you can't fetch that price, then what will you do?
Then I suppose my mother and I will have no food to eat.
Beans? We mustn't give up our beans! Well, if you feel that we must...
What?
Beans will bring you food, son.
Beans in exchange for my cow?
Oh, these are no ordinary beans. These beans carry magic.
Magic? What kind of magic?
Tell him. Magic that defies description.
Why, you would be like to exchange her for a sack of beans.
How many beans?
6. 5. We can't part with all of them. We have to keep one of these beans for ourselves. Besides, I'd say they're worth a pound each at least.
Might I buy my cow back someday?
Well, possibly.
I guess this is goodbye. Perfect friend. I hate to see us part, old pal. Someday I'll buy you back. I'll see you soon again. I hope that when I do, it won't be on a plane.
dispel this curse through deceit.
Come here.
If you know what you want, then you go and you find it and you get it.
Home!
Do we want a child or not? And you give and you take and you bid and you bargain or you live to regret it.
Please go home!
There are rights and wrongs and in-betweens. No one waits when fortune intervenes. And maybe they're really magic. Who knows?
Take the cow and go home. I will carry this out in my own fashion.
And so the baker continued his search for the cape as red as blood. As for Rapunzel, the witch was careful not to lose this beauty to the outside world, and so shut her within a doorless tower that lay deep within the forest. And when the old enchantress paid a visit, she called forth.
Tomorrow, that Harwood drives, I will stand beneath her tower and ask her to let her hair down to me.
Hello there, little one. What might you be doing in the middle of the forest with a good cape like that?
I'm going to my granny's. So.
Is that right? I would love a red cape like this.
Please give it back! I don't like to be without my cape alone! Please give it back!
Forget the little girl and get the cape!
Here. I just wanted to make certain that you really love this cape. Now you go to your granny's and make certain no wolves come your way.
I'd rather a wolf than you any day!
If you know what you need, then you go and you find it and you take it. Do I want a child or not? Things are only what you need them for. What's important is who needs them more. I need that cape.
And so the baker, with newfound determination, continued his search for the cape as red as blood. As for the little girl, she was surprised to find her grandmother's cottage door standing open.
Good day, grandmother. My grandmother. You're looking very strange. What big eyes you have.
The better to see you with, my dear.
And grandmother, what big ears you have.
The better to hear you with, my dear.
And grandmother, what a big, wet, terrible mouth you have.
Better to hear you with.
The wolf, with his appetite appeased, took for a nice long nap.
That grandmother has a mighty snore. Where's the little one? Grandmother, what's that red cloth in the corner of your mouth? I will get the cape within the wolf's stomach.
What a fright! How dark and dank it was inside that wolf!
Kill the devil!
Hey!
Hush, child, the field must be destroyed!
I will leave you to your task.
Don't you want the skins?
No, you keep them.
What kind of a hunter are you? Obviously not a good one.
I'm a baker.
Mother said, straight ahead, not to slag or be misled. I heeded her advice, but he seemed so nice. And he showed me things, many beautiful things that I hadn't thought to explore. They were off my path, so I never had dared. I had been so careful, I never had cared. And he made me feel excited, well, excited and scared. When he said, come in, with that sickening grin, how could I know what was in store? Once his teeth were bare, then I really got scared, well, excited and scared. But he drew me close, and he swallowed me down, down a dark, slimy path, where lie secrets that I never want. before. Do not put your faith in a cape and a hood. They will not protect you the way that they should. And take extra care with strangers. Even flowers have their dangers. And though scary, it's exciting. Nice is different than good. Now I know, don't be scared. Rennie is right, just be prepared. Isn't it nice to know a lot? And a little bit not. Mr. Baker, you saved our lives. Here.
Are you certain?
Yes. Maybe Granny will make me one with the skins of the wolf.
Thank you.
Ugh!
And so the baker, with the second article in hand, feeling braver and more satisfied than ever, ran back through the woods. As for the lad Jack...
Only adults would exchange a cow for beans.
Mother, no.
To bed without supper for you.
Little did they know that those beans would grow into an enormous stalk that would stretch high into the heavens.
Have you seen a beautiful young woman in a ball gown pass through?
I don't think so, sir.
I think I see her over there.
I've never lied to royalty before. I've never anything to royalty before.
Thank you.
Oh my, what a beautiful gown you're wearing. Were you at the King's Festival?
Yes.
Aren't you the lucky one? If the prince were chasing me, I wouldn't hide.
Will you tell me about the ball?
It's a very nice ball.
Yes, and?
They have far too much food.
No, the prince.
Oh, the prince?
Yes, the prince.
If he knew who I really was.
Who?
I'm afraid I was rude.
Oh, how?
Now I'm being pursued.
Yes, and?
And I'm not in the mood.
Are you to return to the festival tomorrow?
Perhaps.
Perhaps? Oh, to be pursued by a prince. All that pursues me is tomorrow's bread. What I wouldn't give to be in your shoes.
Will you look over there? An enormous vine is growing next to that little cot.
I mean slippers.
It looks like a giant leaf frog rising into the sky.
As pure as gold!
Get home.
Wait! I need your shoes! Omelette! Come back! Come back!
There are giants in the sky. There are great, tall, terrible giants in the sky. You look below at the world you left and the things you know. Little more than a glance is enough to show you just how small you are. When way up high you're on your own in a world like none that you've ever known. Where the sky is thin, the earth is stone. You're free to do whatever pleases you. Exploring things you never dare, cause you don't care when suddenly there's a big, tall, terrible giant at the door. Big, tall, terrible giant with a terrible roar. So you steal some gold and away you go. And you scramble down to the world below. And you're back again, only different than before. After the sky. Giants in the sky. They're great, tall, terrible, awesome, scary, wonderful giants in the sky.
Good fortune, good fortune, sir. 5 gold pieces.
5 gold pieces.
Where's my Milky White? You said I might buy her back.
Well, I'm not sure 5 gold pieces would.
Is that not enough? Do you wish me to get more? Keep that, and I will go get more.
Wait, I didn't say... 5 gold pieces. With this money, I could buy baking supplies for a year. I could buy a new chimney and a new thatched roof.
How could you buy yourself a child?
Who are you?
How much do you wish to put on the child's head? 5 gold pieces? 10? 20?
I never thought to put a price on it.
Exactly. The money is not what's important. What's important is that your wish is granted.
Come back here. Get inside. What are you doing here?
I see you have the red cape.
Yes, I have the cape. Only 2 of the 4 items left to locate.
3.
2. I have the cape and the cow.
You have the cape!
What have you done with the cow?
She ran away. I never reached home. I have been looking for her all night.
I should have known better than to entrust her to you.
She might have just as easily have run from you.
But she didn't.
I'm sorry I lost the cow.
I should have yelled. Now please, go back to the village. I will make things right. No more hunting the woods for strange objects. No more witches, dim-witted boys, and hungry little girls. Go!
Ah, good brother. There you are. Father and I had wondered where you had gone.
I have been looking all night. For her. The beautiful one I danced the evening with.
Where did she go?
Disappeared.
I, too, have found a lovely maiden. She lives on the top of a tall tower that has no door or stairs.
And how do you manage a visit?
I stand beneath her tower and say, Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair to me. And then she lowers the longest, most beautiful head of hair, yellow as corn, which I climb to her.
Rapunzel, Rapunzel, what kind of name is that, you jest?
She's as true as your maiden, a maiden running from a prince. Does that make sense? None would run from us.
Yet one has. Did I abuse her, show her disdain? Why does she run from me? If I should lose her, how shall I regain the heart she has won from me? Agony beyond power of speech. When the one thing you want is the only thing out of your reach.
High in a tower, she sits by the hour, maintaining her hair. Blithe and becoming, and frequently humming a light-hearted air. Ah, agony, far more painful than yours, when you know she would go with you. If there only were doors.
Agony, oh, the torture they teach. Always 10 steps behind.
Always 10 feet below.
And she's just out of reach. Agony, that can cut like a knife. I must have her to love.
Two princes, each more handsome than the other. No, get the hair.
Excuse me, young woman. Have you encountered a boy answering to the name of Jack?
Not one partial to the white cow.
He's the one.
Have you seen the cow?
No, and I don't care to ever again. These children.
I wouldn't know. I have no children.
That's good, too.
I have not seen your son today.
I just hope he hasn't run up that beanstalk again.
Jack! Jack!
Moo! Moo! Moo!
Moo! Looking for your cow?
Where did you find her? Low.
What are you doing?
I'm here to make amends.
I want you to keep out of this, old man.
I'm here to see that your wish is granted.
You've caused enough trouble. Keep out of my path.
Ugh.
Yes, it is.
Excuse me for this. You certainly do take a lot of spills, don't you?
It's these slippers.
I'd say that these slippers were as pure as gold.
Yes, they're all you could wish for in beauty.
What I wouldn't give for just one.
One is not likely to do you much good. I must run.
Wait, I need your shoes.
Stop that.
I need these shoes to have a baby.
No, I need to get out of here.
Can't even walk.
Where did she go?
Who?
Don't play the fool, woman.
Oh, you mean that beautiful young woman in the ball gown. She just ran that way. I was trying to hold her here for you.
I can capture my own damsel, thank you.
I see you have the cow.
Yes, I have the cow. We have two of the four items left to locate.
We have three.
Two. I have the key. The cow.
Three. Compare this to your corn.
Where did you find it?
I pulled it from a maiden in a tower.
Three.
And I almost had the fourth, but she just got away.
We have one entire day left. Surely we could go locate the slipper by then.
We? You mean you'll allow me to stay?
Well, perhaps it will take the two of us to have this child.
You've changed, you're daring, you're different in the woods. More sure, more sharing, you're getting us through the woods. If you could see, you're not the man who started, and much more open-hearted.
Was enough, it's not true. It takes two of us, you came through. When the journey was rough, it took you. It took two of us.
It takes care, it takes patience and fear and despair to change. Will you swear to change? You can tell if you do.
It takes two,
we've changed.
And slippers and hoods,
just the two of us beyond lies, safe at home with our beautiful prize. Just the two of us, it takes trust, it takes just a bit more, and we're done. We want four, we had none, we've got three, we need one, it takes two.
My milky white, and its owners, and my hen.
Look what the hen's dropped in his hand.
A golden egg!
I've never seen a golden egg before.
You see, sir, I promised you more than the 5 gold pieces I gave you. Now I'm taking my cow.
I never said I would sell.
But you took the 5 gold pieces.
You took 5 gold pieces!
I didn't take, you gave. You said I might buy my cow back.
I never said you could, I said you might. You would take money before a child? Oh, dear God.
Milky White is dead.
Two!
Two.
midnight's gone, and the exhausted baker and his wife buried the dead Milky White.
You must go to the village in search of another cow. And what do you propose I use to purchase this cow? Here, tell him it's magic. No person with a brain larger than this is going to exchange a cow for a bean.
Then resign yourself to a childless life.
I feel best you go for the cow, as I have met a maiden in the woods in these previous evenings, and I feel I may succeed in attaining one of her golden slippers.
Fine. That's simply fine.
Unfortunately for Rapunzel, the witch discovered her affections for the prince before he could spirit her away.
Why didn't you tell me you were a visitor?
I was lonely atop that tower.
I gave you protection, and yet you disobeyed me.
I am no longer a child. I wish to see the world.
Don't you know what's out there in the world? Someone has to shield you from the world. Stay with me. Princes wait there in the world, it's true. Princes, yes, but wolves and humans.
Cast out Rapunzel to a remote desert, the witch returned to take the prince by surprise. And as he leapt from the tower, the thorns into which he fell pierced his eyes and blinded him.
He's a very smart prince. He's a prince who prepares. Knowing this time I'd run from him. He's Brett Pitch on the stairs. I was caught unawares, and I thought, well, he cares. This is more than just malice. Better stop and take stock while you're standing here stuck on the steps of the palace. Better run along home and avoid the collision. Even though they don't care, you'll be better off there, where there's nothing to choose, so there's nothing to lose. So you pry up your shoes, and come out of the blue, and without any guide. You know what your decision is, which is not to decide. You just leave him a clue, for example, a shoe, and then see what he'll do. Now it's he, not you, who is stuck with a shoe in a stew, in the goo. And you've learned something too, something you never knew. On the steps of the palace.
Don't come any closer to me!
Please, please just hear me out.
We have nothing to discuss. You attacked me once before.
I didn't attack you. I attacked your shoe. I need it. Here. Here, take this magic bean in exchange for it.
Magic bean? None.
Oh, don't do that.
I've already given up one shoe this evening. My feet cannot bear to give up another.
I need that shoe to have a child.
That makes no sense.
Does it make sense that you're running from a prince?
Stop!
Here, take my shoes, you'll run much faster.
Who was that woman?
I do not know, sir.
Lying will cost you your life.
I was the cow. The slipper! We all form the items!
I will give this to the prince, and tomorrow we will search the kingdom for the maiden who fits this slipper.
It's mine! I don't care if this costs me my life!
No! Give them the shoe and all will come to us!
I'm the maiden slipper.
And I, sir, have succeeded in obtaining the other shoe.
Now listen to your elders. Give them the shoe and all will come to a happy end.
Shut up.
Do as he says. He's obviously a spirit of some sort. And we only need one.
Yes.
Down the stalk. Suddenly, with a crash, the beanstalk fell, but there's no sign of Jack. For all I know, he's been crushed by the giant.
If he's been crushed, well, then there's nothing any of us can do. Now, is there? I must be off. I need my rest before tomorrow's search is to commence.
Doesn't anyone care that there's a dead giant in my backyard?
You've all the objects?
Yes.
That cow doesn't look as white as milk to me.
Oh, she is. She is.
This cow's been covered with flour!
We had the cow as white as milk. Honestly, we did.
Well, then where is she?
She's dead. We thought you'd prefer a live one.
Of course I prefer a live cow. Now bring me the dead one and I'll bring her back to life.
Whatever you say.
You could do that? No!
Look, Mother, the most beautiful horse.
I've been worried sick.
Ooh, shame on you. You've stolen way too much.
She is too heavy.
What's happening? Milky white. Now I have my friend back, and I'm rich.
Quiet. Feed the objects to the cow.
What?
You heard me. Feed them to the cow.
I'm so confused.
Fill it.
What?
Fill it.
Ooh. I'll do it. She'll only milk for me. Squeeze, pal.
Wrong ingredients. Forget about a child.
No! We followed your directions exactly. That cow is as white as milk, even though we covered another one with flour before. Two, that cape most certainly is as red as blood. That slipper was as pure as gold.
And four, that hair was as yellow as corn.
I pulled it from a maiden up in-
You what? I touched that hair, don't you understand? I cannot have touched the object!
The corn by the cow.
What?
The silky hair of the corn. Pull it from the ear, feed it to the cow, quickly.
This had better work, old man, or your son will be the last of your flesh and blood.
Son?
Not now.
Yes, meet your father.
Father, could that be you? I thought you died in a baking accident.
I didn't want to run from you, but...
Lou, it's working.
She's milking.
I don't understand.
Not now. Into the cup, quickly. Son!
Father!
All has been repaid! And you, my dad, have a child.
He's dead!
And so, the mysterious man died, having helped lift the curse on his house. For the baker, there would be no reunion with his father, and he and his wife, bewildered, returned home. The witch, who had been plagued with age and ugliness the night her beads were stolen and the lightning flashed, was now returned to her former state of youth and beauty. Milky White, after a night of severe indigestion, was returned to the now wealthy Jack. As for Rapunzel, she lived impoverished in the desert until the day her prince, wandering aimlessly, heard a voice so familiar that he went towards it. And as he approached, Rapunzel, overjoyed at seeing him, fell into his arms and wept. Two of her tears watered his eyes, and their touch restored his vision.
I was going to come fetch you as soon as I thought you had learned your lesson. This is who I truly am. Come with me, child, so we can be happy as we once were.
She will not go with you.
Let her speak for herself. You are the only family I know. Come with me, please. You leave me no choice.
These tales work, in exchange for her youth and beauty, the witch lost her power over others. As for Cinderella's prince, he began a search for the foot to fit the golden slipper, and when he came to Cinderella's house, Cinderella's stepmother took the slipper into Florinda's room. Swallowing her pain, and joined the prince to become his bride. The prince returned the false bride and asked the other sister to try on the shoe. The girl obeyed, swallowing her pain, and joined the prince to become his bride. But once again, the prince noticed the blood coming from within the shoe. And when Cinderella presented herself and tried on the blood-soaked slipper, it fit like a glove.
This is the true bride.
I always did want a son.
In order to gain Cinderella's favor, Cinderella's stepsisters attended her ball. And when they arrived, Cinderella's bird friends swooped down, pecked out their eyes, and blinded them.
Ooh. I see your princess found you.
Yeah.
Thank you for the slipper.
And it came to pass, all that seemed wrong was now right. The kingdoms were filled with joy, and those who deserved it were certain to live a long and happy life. And it's not just for today, but tomorrow, and extended ever after. All the curses have been ended, the reverse is wiped away. All's tenderness and laughter for forever after.
Tenderness and laughter to be happy and forever. You must
and see your wish come true. Don't be careful, don't be clever, when you see your wish pursue. It's a dangerous endeavor, but the only thing to do. Those fearful, those evil, those ugly, they lose the path. If you want your wish, you can have your wish, but you can't just wish. No, to get your wish, you go into the woods where nothing sticks, for witches, ghosts, and wolves appear. Into the woods and through the fear, you have to take the journey. Into the woods and down the dell, and then perhaps go through the dell. Into the woods to lift the spell.
Into the woods to lose the pony.
Into the woods to have the child.
To add the prince.
To get the money.
To save the house.
To kill the wolf.
To find the father.
To come to the king.
To have, to wed, to get, to save, to kill, to keep, to go to the festival. Into the woods.
Into the woods.
Into the woods and out of the woods.
And happy ever after.
To be continued. Once upon a time, later, in the same far-off kingdom, lived a young princess, the lad Jack,
I wish,
and the baker with his family.
No, I miss,
I wish,
more than anything,
more than the moon,
there, there,
I wish to come here fast away,
more than love,
I miss,
trying to come here fast away,
the riches, and
home. I miss my kingdom up in the sky,
more than anything,
I wish we had a room.
Another room.
But despite some minor inconveniences, they were all content.
I never thought I'd find perfection. I never thought I could be so happy.
Not an unhappy moment,
I didn't think we'd be this rich.
Not a conceivable objection.
I never thought we'd have a baby.
I never thought I could be so happy.
I'm so happy.
We're so happy, you're so happy. Just as long as you stay happy, we'll stay happy.
Go, I'm a skunk.
We should really sell this. Where's the cheesecloth?
If only this cottage were just a little bit larger.
I will expand the quarters in due time.
Why expand when we could simply move to another cottage?
This was my father's home, and now it'll be my son's.
You would raise your child alongside a witch?
Why does he always cry when I hold him?
Oh, babies cry. He's fine. You don't need to hold him as if he's so fragile.
Here, he wants his mother.
Oh, I can't take care of him all the time.
I will care for him when he is older.
We had to go through thick and thin.
We had to lose a lot to win.
I ventured out and saw within.
I never thought I'd be so much I hadn't been. I'm so happy.
Are you all right?
I'm okay, and you?
I'm fine, and the baby?
Oh, he's okay.
You have done this to our home.
Always thinking of yourself. Look at my garden.
What of your garden?
Look! Destroyed.
What has happened?
I was thrown to the ground. I saw nothing.
What could do such a thing? An earthquake?
No earthquake. My garden has been trampled. Those are footprints.
Who could do such a thing?
Anything with footprints that large is no who.
Do you think it was a bear?
A bear? Bears are sweet. Besides, you ever see a bear with 40-foot feet?
A dragon?
No scorch marks, usually they're linked.
Manticore?
Imaginary.
Griffin?
Extinct.
Giant?
Possible. Very, very possible.
Giant? Maybe we should tell somebody.
And who are you going to tell?
The royal family, of course.
I wouldn't count on that family to snuff out a rat. With a giant? We shall have to go to battle. A giant's the worst. A giant has a brain. Hard to outwit a giant. A giant's just like us, only bigger. Much, much bigger. So big that we are just an expendable bug beneath its foot. Boom, crunch.
We're moving.
And so the baker proceeded to the castle, but not before visiting Jack and his mother first.
Oh, look, Milky White, it's the butcher.
The baker.
The baker.
What can we do for you, sir? I'm here to report the appearance of a giant on the land.
Jack has been home with me all day.
The baker explained to the two that he believed there was a giant in the kingdom.
I can recognize the giant's footprints. I could go to your house.
You will do no such thing. I am sorry, but no one cared when there was a giant in my backyard. I don't remember you volunteering to come to my aid.
A giant in your backyard was one thing. A crushed house is quite another.
Listen, young man, a giant will never strike the same house twice, I wouldn't worry.
I'm taking the news to the castle, nonetheless.
When the baker reached the castle, it was the princess who greeted his news. The story unfolds.
Excuse me, madam. This small man insists on seeing you.
I'm here to report the appearance of a giant in the land.
Where did you see a giant?
Well, I didn't exactly see the giant.
Then how do you know there's a giant in the land?
My home is crushed. There are footprints.
That could have been done by any number of things. I will show you to the door.
Wait. A nearby household was visited by a giant not too long ago, descending from a beanstalk.
Yes, I remember.
That giant was slain. Now come along.
Wait. Princess, I have a young child. Please. My child was very difficult to come by. His safety is of great importance to me.
Are we entirely through now?
Yes.
I will take this news up with the prince when he returns. Thank you. I'm going off to market, Jack. I want you to stay inside.
But I haven't been outside all day.
Oh, Jack, please. I don't want you out when there might be a giant on the loose.
But I know how to kill a giant.
Please, we've had a fill of giants. Promise me you'll stay inside.
But Mother, I am a man now.
You are still a little boy in your mother's eyes. Now I want you to promise. Promise.
All right, already, I promise.
Good.
What happened to your house?
We've had a baking accident.
Baking accident?
There's no use in frightening the young thing.
You can't frighten her.
Oh, well, I guess Granny will have to do with her bread and sweets. Besides, I have all I can carry.
Oh my, why such a load?
Well, I'm moving with my granny. We had an accident too. I came home to find her house collapsed. As if a big wind blew it in or something. I couldn't find my mother anywhere.
Oh, no.
So I salvaged what I could, and now I'm off.
Oh, good friends, what news have you? What is Mother's grave? What kind of trouble? Oh, I can't investigate. A princess is not supposed to go into the woods unescorted. Good idea. I'll disguise myself and go to see what's wrong. Thank you, birds.
We'll take you to your granny's.
What?
I'm not about to let her go into the woods alone. All right, I will take you.
I don't need anyone to take me. I've gone many times before.
But not when there have been such winds blowing.
That's right. We'll all take you.
No. I'm not going to stay here at this house with a baby when a wind might return here, too.
I know Mother made me promise, but I'm going to find that giant anyway.
The time to sow, I hate to leave, I have to go. Into the woods, it's time to sow, it must begin my journey. Into the woods, the weather's clear, we've been before, we've not to fear. Into the woods, away from here, into the woods to save my child.
Into the woods to slay the giant, I will find it.
Into the woods to grandmother's house. Into the woods to grandmother's house.
Into the woods, the path is straight. No reason then to hesitate. The woods are just trees. The trees are just woods. It's not so late, it's just another journey.
Into the woods, but not too long, this path is straight. Into the woods to see what's wrong.
To slay the giant,
to shield the child.
To shield, to slay, to see, to find, to face, to hide, to see where the trouble is.
Rapunzel, what are you doing here. What's the matter?
Oh, nothing. You just locked me in a tower for 14 years with no company, then blinded my prince and set me off to live in a desert where I had little to eat and again no company, and then grew our twins. Because of the way you treated me, I'll never, ever be happy again.
I was only trying to be a good mother.
Rapunzel, stay with me. There's a giant running about.
Ah, brother. What a surprise.
Good brother. How nice to see you.
What brings you into the wood today?
I am investigating news of a giant.
You? Investigating news of a giant? Father would not even do that. That is business for your steward, or less.
Well, what are you doing in the woods?
My Rapunzel has run off.
Run off?
She's a changed woman. She's been subjected to hysterical fits of crying, moods that no soul could predict. I know not what to do.
What a pity.
And Cinderella?
She remains well.
Does she? Now, brother, do tell what you're really doing in the wood today.
High in a tower like yours was, but higher up beauteously. All round the tower, a thicket of briar 100 feet deep. Agony, no frustration more keen. When the one thing you want is the thing that you've not even seen.
I found a casket entirely of glass. No, it's unbreakable. Inside, don't ask it, a maiden alas, just as unwakeable.
Agony, such that princes must weep.
She has skin white as snow.
Did you learn her name?
No, there's a dwarf standing guard.
Agony, not to know what you miss. While they lie there for years,
and you cry on their beards,
what unbearable bliss. Agony that can cut like a knife.
Ah, well, back to my wife. Rapunzel, Godspeed, brother.
Godspeed.
Are you sure this is the right direction?
We went down, down. Perhaps you forgot the way.
The path is straight.
Why straight? There is no path now.
Where's the stream? Where's Lipon? Where's Granny?
Calm down. We would just have to find Granny's house without the path.
No!
I think we should go back to the village.
Wait, that looks familiar. See in the distance? Three oak trees.
Yes, I recognize.
Who might that be?
It's the steward in the royal family. What brings you into the woods?
The castle has been set upon by a giant.
Oh, no.
I warned you. Why didn't you do something?
I don't make policies. I just carry them out.
And I warned you. You can't count on a royal family to help solve your problems. I think it's best that we go back to the village right away. It's not safe here.
I wouldn't be in such a rush to get back if I were you. There's not much left of your house.
Oh, no.
What? All that's left of my garden is this sack of beans. And
what
your
has
house
happened
is
to
in
our
shambles.
House? No. But I heard giants never strike the same house twice.
You heard wrong.
Well, maybe we should go back to.
The giant's a woman? That size!
You have no mother!
And who destroyed my house? That boy has foreshadowed.
your breath.
She's right. You can't reason with a dumb giant.
We told you he's not here.
The girl speaks the truth.
The giant, who was nearsighted, remained convinced that she had found the lad. There was no consensus among the group as to which course of action to take.
Put a spell on her!
I no longer have my powers. If I did, do you think I'd be standing here with you? Now, we shall have to give her someone.
Who?
The steward. It's in his line of duty to give up his life.
Don't be ridiculous. I'm not giving up my life for anyone.
You must understand, these were not people familiar with making decisions. Their past experiences in the woods had not in any way prepared them to deal with a force this great.
Excuse me. Would you like a blind girl instead? How dare you?
Put them out of their misery.
We're not that miserable.
What are you talking about?
She doesn't want a woman.
Well, then what do you suggest we do?
It is interesting to examine the moral question at issue here. The finality of stories such as these dictates. Sorry, I tell a story, I'm not part of it.
That's right.
Not one of us.
Always on the outside.
That's my role, you must understand. There must always be someone on the outside.
You're going to be on the inside now. Aha!
Make a big mistake.
Nonsense!
Dragman's a smash will be lost. You'll never know how the story ends.
Some of us don't like the way you've been telling it.
You think it'd be fun when you have to tell the story yourselves?
Wait, he's right. He's the only one that knows the story.
Think of your baby.
He's right. We have to leave him alone. Put that knife away, young lady.
That's better. You don't want to live in a world of chaos. There must always be...
Here's the lad!
I'm not the lad!
Push him into our arms.
You wanted to get rid of him too.
We might have thought of something else.
If it was up to you, a decision would never be made.
Now that he's gone, we'll never know what happens next.
It's okay, we'll manage.
My eyes are among you.
No!
Jack is just a boy. We've had no food to eat, and he sold his beloved cow in exchange for magic beans.
Shh.
If anyone is to be punished, it's the man who made that exchange. Too. Do you think it was a picnic disposing of your husband's remains? What about our anger? What about our loss? Who's been flouncing about our kingdom?
Don't upset the giant.
I will hide my son and you'll never find him. You'll never, never find him. And if you don't go back this instant...
Stay here.
The boy is hiding in the steeple tower. You can find him there.
Yes, that's true.
Yes.
Rapunzel, Rapunzel.
If he is not, I will return and find you.
Don't step on that.
She's in poor condition.
Wake up. Please don't let them get Jack.
We won't.
Promise me you won't let him be hurt as I stand here at death's door.
I will do what I can.
Promise!
All right, I promise.
Jack. No, no! Come away from there! It was you! You killed her!
I was thinking of the greater good. That's my job.
Behind walls, as I
When are things going to return to normal?
We must depart if we are to arrive before nightfall.
Where are you going?
We're off to a hidden kingdom.
Shh! We can't take everyone.
Fools! There's nowhere to hide.
We have to stay together.
I do not have the constitution. Some people are cut out to battle giants, and others are not. We are going to hide. Don't worry, everything will turn out fine in the end.
Not always.
I hope the giant crushes them all.
You shouldn't say that.
You were thinking the same thing.
This is horrible. We just saw 3 people die.
Since when were you so squeamish? How many wolves have you carved up?
A wolf is not the same!
Ask a wolf's mother!
Stop it!
I suggest we find that boy now and give the giant what she wants.
But if we give her the boy, then she'll kill him too!
And if we don't, she'll kill half the kingdom!
Well, we can't let him die. He's just a boy. He should just apologize and make amends.
Yes, he will return all the stolen goods.
He's really a sweet boy at heart. The giant will see that.
You people are so blind. It's because of that boy there's a giant in our land. Now, while you stand around here talking about the problem, I shall find the land and I'll feed him to the giant for life!
We're not going to give him the boy, are we?
No, of course not.
I will just have to find him first.
I'll go too.
No, you stay here with the baby.
We'll fan out and it'll increase our chances of finding him. I want to come too.
No, you stay here with my baby.
You would leave our child
with her?
The baby's sleeping. The giant will not harm them, don't worry.
How do you know?
I just know.
But what if?
But what if?
But what if?
Well, only a giant could stop your arguing. 100 paces, go.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
Are you in the woods in search of a giant?
Yes. Now leave me to my business.
Have you come across the giant today?
No!
I have.
You have?
Yes.
Jack! Jack! 81, 82, 83.
What's wrong, ma'am?
The tree has fallen. Mother's grave destroyed.
Oh, I'm sorry.
My wishes have just been crushed.
Don't say that.
No, it's true. You wouldn't understand.
Well, it's not safe here. There's a giant on the loose.
I'm sure that the prince will see to it that the giant is rid from our land.
There's been no sign of the prince. No doubt he's off seducing some young maiden.
What?
I understand that's what princes do.
Not every prince.
You look just like the princess, but dirty.
Wait, you are the princess. Please get up, get up. I'm not the princess here.
What are you to do?
I must be on my way back to the castle.
You haven't heard? The castle has been set upon by a giant.
And the prince?
There's been no sign of him. Now you must come with me. You'll be safe in our company.
I must leave.
Why?
The giant.
The giant. I had almost forgotten.
I must go and slay a giant. That is what the next moment holds for me. I shall never forget you. How brave you are to be in the woods.
Okay. 81, 80.
Oh, God.
81.
Where is she? She should have been back by now.
Yeah, she should have.
I'm sure she will return.
I must go and search for her. I will count 100 paces from here.
1.
Here's the lad.
Please don't let her feed me to the giant.
It's not our fault the giant wants you.
You're hurting me.
Let go of him.
Leave him alone.
Where did you find this? Where's my wife?
I'm sorry, sir. I found her under a tree.
She's dead.
What?
He was sobbing over her like she was his own mother.
How could I have let this happen?
I should have insisted on her staying back at the village.
Remorse will get you nowhere.
My wife is dead!
Wake up! People are dying all around you. You're not the only one to have suffered a loss. When you're dead, you're dead. Now, I suggest we give that boy to the giant now before we're all so much dead.
Get away from him!
Boom, crunch!
Yes, it's because of him there's a giant in our midst, and my wife is dead.
But it is my fault I was given those beans. You persuaded me to trade my cow for beans, and without those beans, there'd been no self-doubt to giants in the first place.
Wait a minute, magic beans for a cow so old that you had to lie to sell it, what you taught, were they worthless beans with it over salt? Tell us who persuaded you to steal that goat.
So it's your fault.
No.
So it's your fault.
No.
Yes, it is.
It's not.
It's true.
Wait a minute, though, I only stole the gold to get my cow back from you.
So it's your fault.
No, it isn't. I kept those beans, but our house was cursed. She made us get the cow to get the first reverse.
It's your father's fault that the curse got placed and the place got cursed in the first place.
Oh, then it's his fault.
So?
It was his fault.
No.
Yes, it is. It's his.
I guess.
Wait a minute, though. I chopped down the beanstalk, right? That's clear. Then without any beanstalk, then what's queer is how did the second giant get down here in the first place? Second place?
Yeah.
How?
What about the other bean?
The other bean?
The other bean?
You pocketed the other bean.
No, I didn't. Yes,
that
I did.
Yours.
No, it isn't, because I gave
those
beans.
So it's her!
No, it isn't.
Then whose is it?
Wait a minute. She exchanged those beans to obtain your shoes, so the one that's happened to the bean is you.
You mean that old bean that your wife owed dear, but I never knew, and so I threw. Well, don't look here.
So it's your fault.
But.
Then it's her fault.
But.
And it isn't mine at all.
Shh. We can always give her the boy.
No.
No, of course. What really matters is the blame. Someone you can blame. Fine. That's the thing you enjoy, placing the blame. If that's the aim, give me the blame. Just give me the boy.
No.
No. You're so nice. You're not good. You're not bad. You're just nice. I'm not good. I'm not nice. I'm the witch. You're the I'm the hitch, I'm what no one believes, I'm the witch. You're all liars and thieves like his father, like his son will be too. Oh, why bother? You'll just do what you do, it's the last midnight. So goodbye, all, coming at you fast. Midnight soon, you'll see the sky fall. Here, you want a bean? Have another bean. Beans are made for making you rich, plant them and they soar. Here, you want some more? Listen to the roar, giants by the score. Oh, well, you can blame another witch. It's the last midnight. It's the last verse. Now, before it's past midnight, I'm leaving you my last curse. I'm leaving you alone. Here, you tend the garden. It's yours, separate and alone. Everyone down on all fours. I read Mother Wen. Lost the beans again. Punish me the way you did then. Give me claws and a hunch just away from this bunch and that gloom. And that doom, and that boom.
Maybe I shouldn't have stolen from the giant.
Maybe I shouldn't have strayed from the path.
Maybe I shouldn't have attended the ball.
Yes, maybe you shouldn't have.
Where are you going?
Away from here.
But we need your help.
It doesn't matter if we're together or apart.
But you said we had to get through this together.
You don't understand. I depended on my wife for everything. She knew what to do.
You would leave your child?
Here. My child would be happier in the arms of a princess.
But wait.
You were dead.
Not completely. Yet, are we ever?
As far as I am concerned, you are.
Is that true?
Yes.
Listen, this is all happening because I ran into that garden to give your mother a gift. And I foolishly took some of those magic beans for myself. How are we to know? How are we ever to know? And when your mother died, I ran from my guilt. Aren't you doing the same?
No.
Aren't you running away?
No more questions, please.
Running away, but where are we to go? Where are we ever to go? Running away, we'll do it. Why sit around resigned? Trouble is son, the farther you run, the more you feel undefined. For what you have left undone, and more, what you have left behind.
We disappoint in turn, I guess, I thought, no more.
Like father, like son.
No more giants, raging wars. Can't we just pursue our lives? How do we ignore all the witches, all the curses, all the wolves, all the false hopes, all wondering what worse is still in store?
All the children, all the giants, no more.
I knew you wouldn't give up.
He wouldn't leave his baby.
Looked like he was going to.
Give me my son. He always cries when I...
What are we to do now?
We must make a plan.
How?
Think.
We need to surprise her.
It's too big to surprise.
Oh, good friends, I need your help now more than ever.
What of the prince?
I don't care. What's important now is that we find a way to fell the giant. How can you help? You could do that? How can I ever thank you?
You could talk to the birds.
The birds will help.
How?
When the giant returns, they will attack her and peck out her eyes until she's blind. Then she'll stagger about and crush us all.
Smear the ground with pitch.
Yes.
We'll lure her to the area smeared with pitch.
Her feet will thicken, she won't be able to move.
And I will climb a tree and strike her from behind with my club.
I will go too. It might take two mighty blows.
I'm excited!
I'm gonna kill another giant!
We must find the pitch. You stay here with the baby.
Now, don't cry, little one. I know, you want your mother.
Hello.
The giant went in that direction.
My darling, what are you doing with in those clothes? And with the child? You must go back to the castle at once. There is a giant on the loose.
The giant has been to the castle.
No! Are you all right? My love, why are you being so cold?
Because maybe I'm not your only love, am I?
I love you. Truly, I do. But yes, it's true.
Why, if you loved me, would you have strayed?
I thought if you were mine, that I would never wish for more. And part of me is content and as happy as I have ever been. But there remains a part of me that continually needs more.
I have, on occasion, wanted more, but it doesn't mean I went in search of it. If this is how you behave as a prince, what kind of king will you be?
I was raised to be charming, not sincere. I did not ask to be king. I am not perfect, I am only human.
I think you should go.
Leave, but I do love you.
My father's house is a nightmare. Your house is a dream. Now I want something in between. Please go.
I shall always love the maiden who ran away.
And died far away, prince.
You see over there, between those two trees? When the giant comes, we are to send her over there.
Good.
I want to climb too.
I'm glad you're here to help me. What's wrong?
My granny's gone.
Oh no, I'm so sorry.
I think my granny and my mother would be upset with me.
Why?
They always told me to make them proud. And here I am about to kill somebody.
Not a somebody, a giant who's been doing harm.
Aren't we supposed to forgive? I think my mother would be very unhappy with these circumstances.
Mother cannot guide you. Now you're on your own. Only me beside.
I wish.
I know.
Wait until my mother hears I have slain another giant.
Jack, your mother is dead.
What? Was she killed by the giant?
She was arguing with the giant, trying to protect you. And she was killed by the still with deadly blow.
Oh no. Why would he do that?
He was afraid she was provoking the giant.
After we slay the giant, I will slay him.
He'll do nothing of the kind.
Why not?
Because that would be wrong.
What he did was wrong. He should be punished.
He will be somehow.
How?
I don't know. Stop asking me questions I cannot answer.
I'm going to kill him.
Then kill him. Wait, no, don't kill him.
Just remember.
Someone is on our side. Someone else is not. While we're seeing our side. Our side. Maybe we forgot. Alone, no one is alone. Hard to see the light.
let it go.
Things will come out right now. We can make it so. Someone is on your side.
Here she comes. Remember, don't let her know our plan.
We don't know.
Yes, we do. We can't go on hiding many longer. He must pay the price for his wrongdoings. See that tree where the birds are clustered? Jack is in that tree hiding. Ouch.
She doesn't look happy.
Good bird. The glove is stuck in her head.
She's bleeding all over.
She's beginning to sway.
She's falling.
Watch out.
After yourself. Jack, it is time.
No, it's not. I'll take care of him.
You will?
Yes, I will be your mother now.
I don't want another mother. I want a friend. And a pet.
Of course, we have nowhere to stay. So we'll stay with you.
Oh, no.
It'll be fun.
My house is shambles.
It'll be fun.
Of course, you can stay with me.
And you will join us, too.
You will not return to the castle.
I'll gladly help you with your house. There are times when I actually enjoy cleaning.
How proud my wife would have been, and yet how sad my child will never know her. Maybe I just wasn't meant to have a child.
Don't say that. Of course you were meant to have children.
But how am I to be a father with no one to mother my child?
Just calm the child.
Yes, calm the child.
Look, tell him the story of how it all happened. Be father and mother. You'll know what to do.
Alone?
Sometimes people leave you halfway through the wood. Do not let it grieve you. No one leaves for good. You are not alone. No one is alone. Hold him to the light now. Let him see the glow. Things will turn out right now. Tell him what you know.
Once upon a time, in a far-off kingdom, lived a young maiden, a sad young lad, and the childless baker with his wife.
Careful the things you say. Children will listen.